Ethan Shaler and his team propose a lunar railway system that uses magnetic levitation to transport cargo efficiently across the moon's surface. Named Float for flexible levitation on a track, this innovative solution promises to outperform traditional wheeled rovers in efficiency, durability, and dust resistance, addressing big challenges for lunar-based development. Building and expanding a lunar base requires moving vast quantities of cargo, propellants, and raw materials. Mining lunar resources such as water ice, metals, and propellants demands excavating and processing thousands and eventually millions of tons of regolith. As lunar bases grow with new habitats, outposts, and multiple launch and landing pads, the demand for material transport will increase exponentially. A reliable, scalable transport system is essential to meet those needs. Float offers a low-mass, low-infrastructure alternative to traditional roads, railways, or cable systems. The system uses unpowered magnetic robots that levitate over a flexible film track, eliminating the wear and tear issues common with rovers. Autonomous rovers like NASA's Curiosity rely on complex software and hardware, move slowly, and often require human intervention due to faults. Float, on the other hand, provides a simple, reliable solution. Its tracks define clear routes for unsupervised transport using straightforward sensing and control mechanisms. Float's design offers benefits for small space startups focused on mining and processing lunar regolith for valuable resources like water, ice, or propellants. Its low-maintenance, dust-resistance system ensures reliable transport over long distances, supporting the growth of lunar infrastructure. By reducing reliance on complex, fault-prone rovers, Float simplifies transporting cargo and payloads across the moon's surface. Let's now look first at the Float robots, and then we'll look at the track. Float robots. Float robots are simple, designed as flat arrays of small permanent magnets topped with cargo trays. These unpowered dumb haulers require no batteries or motors, making them lightweight at approximately 3 kilos per square meter. Scalable from palm size to meter wide, they adapt to various cargo needs. A fleet of Float robots can transport hundreds of tons of regolith across kilometers daily, using less than 2 kilowatts of power, 100 times more energy efficient than traditional wheeled rovers. With no moving parts, Float robots levitate across the track, avoiding the abrasive lunar dust that wears down wheeled, legged, or tracked robots. This design ensures exceptional durability and minimal maintenance, making them ideal for reliable, large-scale lunar transport. Float track. The Float system relies on a lightweight and modular track measuring just a few millimeters thick. The track requires no foundations, embankments, or ground preparation. Simply roll it out on the lunar surface for rapid deployment. Its flexibility allows easy rerouting. Roll up the track and reposition it as needed. The track consists of modular panels with flexible joints, enabling it to handle small bumps and adapt to the moon's uneven terrain. Built to withstand extreme lunar temperature swings from minus 120 degrees during the lunar night to over 170 degrees Celsius during the day, the track remains reliable in harsh conditions. Testing shows that robots with flexible joints can navigate curved craters, hugging uneven ground effectively. The three-layer track system. The Float track comprises three layers. 1. Graphite layer. This base layer repels the robot's strong magnets, enabling passive diamagnetic levitation. Robots float 50 to 100 micrometers above the track, avoiding contact with abrasive lunar dust. 2. Flex circuit layer. Embedded coils generate electromagnetic pulses, acting like a frictionless conveyor belt to propel and steer robots along the track. And 3. Optional solar layer. A thin film solar panel generates electricity during the lunar day, powering the system and potentially nearby equipment or habitats. Testing demonstrates that Float robots can travel over 600 meters without wear, a critical advantage in the lunar environment, where sticky abrasive dust degrades traditional rovers. A large-scale Float system can move 100 tons of regolith or payload multiple kilometers daily, consuming less than 40 kilowatts of power, 100 to 1,000 times more energy efficient than lunar rovers. a full-scale float system capable of hauling 80 tons of lunar soil daily over 10 kilometers requires 1,300 robots and a 20-kilometer track, with a total system mass of 30 tons. This can be delivered in 10 Blue Origin Mark 1 lunar lander missions or a single Starship landing. Power needs are met by the track's solar layer or external sources, such as NASA's planned 100-kilowatt nuclear reactor by 2030, or lunar masts from companies like Honeybee Robotics, which can also generate 100 kilowatts per mast. The float system is ideal for repetitive hauling tasks, efficiently moving excavated materials to processing sites. Its low maintenance, dust-resistant design and minimal power requirements make it the perfect solution for supporting lunar mining and base expansion. Environmental considerations. Float will operate autonomously in a dusty, inhospitable lunar environment with minimal site preparation, and its network of tracks can be rolled up, reconfigured over time to match evolving lunar-based mission requirements. The float team have tested their robots in a vacuum chamber. Future plans include testing in lunar regolith analog environments, suborbital flights, and perhaps tech demos on future lunar lander missions. Phase 1 proposal and final report. The Phase 1 report on the float concept confirms its viability as a transformative lunar logistics system. Prototypes demonstrated stable levitation with payloads exceeding 30 kilos per square meter, and effective dust management using secondary sweeper robots clear the track. The system successfully navigated non-flat surfaces and withstood the extreme temperature fluctuations of the lunar day-night cycle. Despite these successes, challenges remain. Long-term durability and thermal management require further investigation to ensure sustained performance in the lunar environment. The report concludes that float could revolutionize lunar logistics, particularly for commercial mining of resources like water ice and propellants. Phase 1 findings confirm the feasibility of meter-scale robots and kilometer-scale tracks, laying a strong foundation for scalable operations. Building on these results, NASA has committed funding for further development of the float system to address open challenges and advance its potential for lunar missions. Phase 2 proposal. Phase 2 focuses on reducing risk in manufacturing, deploying, and controlling the robots and tracks, while further validating the system's potential for lunar logistics. Key objectives for Phase 2. Prototype development. The float team will construct additional subscale robots and track prototypes, resulting in a demonstration within a lunar analog testbed to simulate real-world conditions. Environmental testing. The study will investigate the impact of lunar environmental factors such as extreme temperatures, radiation, electrostatic charging, and abrasive lunar dust on system performance and longevity. Technology roadmap. The team will define a clear technology roadmap, identifying gaps and maturing critical hardware, including large area magnetic arrays and flex circuit boards. High fidelity simulations. Enhanced simulations will model the float system, greater accuracy to refine its design and performance. And flight testing opportunities. The team will explore suborbital flight tests, such as those offered by Blue Origin or Zero-G flights, to verify the technology's functionality in microgravity. Additionally, they aim to include technology demonstrations on future lunar lander missions through NASA's Commercial Lunar Payload Services program. Phase 2 will advance the float system towards operational readiness, ensuring it meets the demands of efficient, scalable lunar transport for future missions. The ecosystem, competitors, partners, funding, and supply chain. The primary competitor to float as the first lunar transport infrastructure is traditional lunar roads. Roads are relatively inexpensive to construct compared to other alternatives and provide immediate benefits for small-scale missions, whether crewed or robotic. They support exploration and site surveying, particularly near the Moon's South Pole. However, roads require surface preparation and maintenance, while float provides a low-maintenance solution. Another alternative is the lunar rail network, which relies on complex infrastructure. Rail systems demand autonomous robots to clear routes, large-scale 3D printers to create sleepers from lunar regolith, a lunar foundry to produce tracks, and additional facilities like stations, warehouses, power systems, communications, and lighting. In contrast, float simplicity requires no site preparation and minimal infrastructure. The track is rolled out and powered, with optional solar panels enabling self-sustained operation for smaller payloads. Lunar landers also offer point-to-point mass transfer, but their feasibility depends on a steady supply of propellant, making them less practical for repetitive, large-scale transport compared to float. Currently, NASA provides the primary funding for the float system through its Phase 1, Phase 2 studies. No commercial companies are known to be developing magnetic levitation systems for lunar transport. While specific partners and supply chain details are not outlined, float's minimal infrastructure requirements reduce dependency on complex lunar manufacturing. The system's lightweight modular tracks and unpowered robots simplify production and deployment compared to rail or road systems. Potential future partners could include companies involved in lunar lander missions, such as those in NASA's Commercial Lunar Payload Services program, or space startups involved in power, lighting, communications, or habitats for the moon. Upcoming events. NASA has awarded the float project $600,000 in Phase 2 funding over 2 years to advance its magnetic levitation system for lunar cargo transport. This funding builds on Phase 1 successes, enabling the team to tackle technical challenges such as system durability in the moon's harsh environment. The team aims to refine the system's ability to transport payloads up to 33 kilos per square meter over kilometer-scale tracks at speeds exceeding 0.5 meters per second, while maintaining low power consumption, under 40 kilowatts for large networks. These advancements will ensure reliability and scalability for lunar logistics. A successful Phase 2 could pave the way for Phase 3, where float transitions to mission applications or commercial partnerships, potentially leading to a lunar railway by the 2030s. This low-cost and low-maintenance system promises to reduce cargo transport costs to the moon, supporting the growth of lunar bases and resource mining. What are your thoughts on using magnetic levitation for lunar cargo transport? Share your opinions in the comments below. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this space video, consider buying me a coffee to help fund more episodes like this. The link is in the description. Space News Live is on Saturday evening or Sunday morning, depending where you watch from. The live stream is a great way for you to share your thoughts and opinions on the videos I posted this week or on any space topic in general. I highlight the most thought-provoking comments on videos I've received, along with late-breaking space news and previews of upcoming content. If you've got the time, please tune in and say hi. Be sure to like and subscribe so you'll see our upcoming videos. We make videos every week covering the space industry, with an emphasis on the smaller space startups that aren't covered so well on other channels. See you soon.